If you have a wish for an AI that doesn't just give you answers, but thinks with you, builds solutions, and brainstorms like a genius, you're in the right place. Meet DeepSeek, an open source AI assistant that's faster, smarter, and more affordable than most AI tools out there. And the best part, it's completely free to use. In this video, I'll show you exactly how DeepSeek works, and I'll break down 4 game-changing use cases that you can leverage for your business to save over 10 hours a week. Whether you need help with strategy, automation, or even website building, this tool does it all. Before we get started, make sure to hit subscribe so you'll never miss out on the latest AI tools or strategies. And if you want even more exclusive insights, then be sure to sign up for my newsletter using the link in the description below. So let's dive in. To get started, simply visit DeepSeek.com. You'll notice an announcement right on top saying DeepSeek R1 is now live and open source. It's a powerful model competing with OpenAI that you can access via a web app, a mobile app, or an API. What's really exciting is the Deep Think button. When you activate it, the AI doesn't just give you answers. It breaks down its thinking process step by step, showing you exactly how it reaches the conclusion. It's kind of like ChatGPT's R1 model, but with an extra layer of transparency, making it perfect for solving complex reasoning problems. Plus, it comes with a built-in web search feature that means that it can pull real-time information from the internet and provide sources to back up its answers. Apart from that, you can upload up to 50 documents with each up to 100 megabytes. These features make it a flexible tool for a wide range of business cases. Now that we've covered the basics, let's dive into the real-world applications that you will be able to leverage to supercharge your business. First up, let's talk about DeepSeek's advanced reasoning ability. Let's say I need a solid marketing campaign for an automation tool like Make, targeting small business owners. By the way, you will be able to find all the prompts in the description below. I'll just ask for a marketing campaign and I'll mention my target audience and my budget. First, I need to define what results focused means here. What I find fascinating about DeepSeek is how intuitive it feels once you actually read through the entire thinking process, how it's analyzing the problem, and also when it remembers something. Like, wait, the user mentioned streamline the workflow. Just look at how many words it generates. By the time it's done, it generated 534 words and thought about different ideas. It suggests to aim for 1,000 signups with a 20% conversion rate, which should be very realistic. And what I really like about it is how it suggests to frame the price, less than 35 cents per day for teams to automate workflows. That's a smart way to anchor the value. And it comes up with a projection that we would break even in 4 to 6 months, making 2 to 6K in reoccurring revenue. Of course, I could fine-tune these numbers by adding even more data, like customer lifetime value, to get more accurate insights. Now let's put DeepSeek's web search function to the test so we can find out what channels are actually performing for an automation tool based on industry data and trends. I can immediately see the source links, which reminds me a little bit of Perplexity and which is great for fact-checking. But when I actually check out these links, some sources aren't clearly cited and there are no data points or benchmarks. For a research tool, I would expect to see data reports or at least direct references to some of the sources. So while the web search is great for general insights, so if you really need data-backed information, you might have to do some manual fact-checking here. Use case number 2 is building tools and calculators. People love interactive tools that give them instant actionable answers, whether it's a pricing estimator, a cost calculator, or another interactive tool that helps convert visitors into potential customers. So let's see how DeepSeek can handle this. I'll ask it to build a marketing cost ROI calculator for me. It's so funny to see how it thinks. It recognizes common marketing costs like SEO, content creation, and advertising, and automatically creates the right fields that are seen as numbers. And in under a minute, it generated the ROI cost calculator. How efficient is this? And the fact that you can run the code directly in DeepSeek? That's next level. Let's check it out and test it. It looks nice and simple. So right now I'll just come up with a bunch of numbers and then hit calculate ROI. And boom, my ROI is around 17%. For someone who's not a developer like me, this completely changes the game. Suddenly, building tools isn't just possible. It's faster, easier, and more accessible than ever. Which brings me to number 3, building landing pages. Let's say you just came up with a brilliant business idea and now you're looking for a website to promote it. What if you could describe the website in a single prompt and let AI build it for you? That's exactly what I'll test now. I'll ask DeepSeek to create a one-page website for a B2C marketing consulting service, making sure it's modern, sleek, and well-designed. I will also test out if it can actually hyperlink a button. All right, let's see what it's thinking here. So it starts by outlining the structure, then adding the features, and finally going into styling. And just like that, it's done. How quick was that? Let's see the result. This is an amazing start. It's very simple and on point. I can also check the button, and yes, this also works. Now I can give feedback and refine it more to my taste. I want to add a personal touch by including a profile picture at the bottom of the page, so ask it for that. And since DeepSeek cannot host images on its own, I will already add a link to my hosted image. Let's see what happened. Perfect. The image is there, just like I wanted. At this point, I can continue to adjust the layout and refine the details, just like I would be working with a developer in real time. And what's even more impressive is if anything isn't working, I can tell DeepSeek about it and it will debug it for me instantly. Which brings me to my last point, performance simulation. Have you ever wished you could test an ad campaign before spending a dollar? Imagine being able to compare how different platforms perform so you know exactly where to invest your budget. Well, that's where DeepSeek gets really interesting. I want to see what kind of results I can expect for an automation tool targeting small business owners, and I want to compare Instagram versus LinkedIn. Now check this out. DeepSeek breaks everything down for you and it actually customizes the approach for each platform. For LinkedIn, it leans into professionalism. It suggests carousel ads, single image ads, and white paper downloads. For Instagram, it comes up with a different strategy and it focuses on reels and carousel ads. And I love the suggestion to use the white paper content for Instagram guides and the link in the bio. And here's what's even more impressive. DeepSeek automatically adjusts the targeting parameters based on how each platform works. On LinkedIn, it recommends targeting by job title and company size, while on Instagram, it shifts to solopreneurs. When it comes to results, it predicts that the cost per lead on LinkedIn will be around $29 compared to $23 on Instagram. Now, if I compare this to industry benchmarks, it seems pretty close. Now, would I take these numbers as an absolute truth? Not necessarily. While AI is great at pattern recognition, you should always validate assumptions before making big business decisions. For example, while Instagram might have a lower cost per lead, LinkedIn tends to have higher quality leads. And in this case, it's even mentioned, but that really depends on the output that you get. DeepSeek's insights are not 100% perfect, but they still give me a solid starting point, which is incredibly valuable. In any case, it's changing the game for coding, business strategy, and automation, making it more accessible than ever, even for non-technical users. If this is where we're at right now, imagine what's next. If you learned something new today, then be sure to hit that like button and let me know in the comments below, what is your favorite feature of DeepSeek? I'd love to hear how you're using it. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one.